Hello world! It's been more than a month since my last video. In fact, recently I'm busy writing the documentation for Zeal 8-bit computer motherboard. But let's take a break from the technical stuff for a moment. I want to share something special with you. Last year, while I was at home, I stumbled upon a gem from my childhood, Pokémon Blue. This Gen 1 Pokémon game holds a special place in my heart as I played it the most during my childhood. Needless to say, the save file in the game cartridge carries a great sentimental value for me. However, as you may know, the saves are not permanent. In fact, the first generation of Pokémon games can retain the saves for approximately 20 to 25 years. Considering I acquired my cartridge in 1999 or 2000, time is running out. In today's episode, we will explore how we can create a backup of the save file using an 8-bit computer. Let's get started. To understand the problem, let's take a look at how Gameboy cartridges are made. There are several types of cartridges, with the simplest ones consisting of a single ROM chip. Many popular games fall into this category, such as Dr. Mario, Tetris, and Super Mario Land. However, games like Pokémon Blue are more complex. Let's open it up and see what's inside. We find multiple chips, including the ROM, which can be larger than 32 kilobytes, an MBC, or Memory Bank Controller, that manages the bank switching to access the entire ROM, and embedded RAM. It's in the RAM chip that the save data is stored. Yes, you heard it right. The save data is stored in a volatile memory. That's why there is a battery in the cartridge. The battery allows the RAM to never turn off, so never lose the data inside. Even if the game is not inserted in the Game Boy, the battery still powers the RAM. The battery life depends on the game and its features. For example, games with a real-time clock feature like Pokémon Gold or Silver consume more power and drain the battery within a few years. In the case of Pokémon Blue, we have 1 MB of ROM and 32 KB of RAM. My goal is to replace the battery, but before doing that, I need to backup the RAM content. And guess what? We will do that with the help of a homebrew 8-bit computer. Now, let's examine how the Game Boy accesses the ROM and RAM in the cartridge. Upon power-up, the memory is mapped as follows. The first 32 KB is mapped to the ROM, divided into two 16 KB sections, a fixed section always pointing to the first part of the ROM, and a banked section that can point to any 16 KB portion of the ROM. The next 8 KB is the console's video RAM, which is not relevant to our purpose. Let's ignore it. Then comes the 8 KB of external RAM, which corresponds to the RAM in the cartridge. This section is also banked because the cartridge may have more than 8 KB of RAM, just like Pokémon Blue. All these memory banks can be switched using software, as we will explore later. Now that we understand how the Game Boy accesses the cartridge, let's take a look at how it physically connects to the console. Here is the pinout from left to right. 5V power input, CPU clock, write signal, read signal, external RAM chip select, 16-bit address, 8-bit data, reset signal, audio, usually unused, and ground. All the signals with a bar on the top are active low. From our earlier discussion, we can infer that the RAM chip select signal goes low when the CPU attempts to access any address between A000 and BFFF in hex. Similarly, address 15 should be set low when communicating with the ROM. If both address 15 and RAM chip select are high, the cartridge remains inactive and does not affect any ongoing console operations. This is crucial to ensure the cartridge doesn't interfere with the console. We now comprehend how the cartridge works and how the Game Boy communicates with it. Let's try replicating the process without an actual Game Boy. If you follow my 8-bit computer project, the Zeal 8-bit computer, you may know that the computer has an extension port. This port provides access to all the signals, addresses, and data lines of the processor, the Z80. Therefore, my plan is to plug the Game Boy cartridge into that port and allow the Z80 CPU to read its RAM as if it was a regular memory. To interface it with the cartridge, I will need to add it to the memory mapping and establish communication. On the 8-bit computer, we have a total of 4 MB of physical address space. To simplify the logic, I will allocate the last 64 KB of memory from the end of the mapping for the Game Boy cartridge. Thus, the cartridge will be mapped from address 3F0000 to 3FFFFF in hex. We cannot change the banking system, as it's part of the cartridge itself. So, once again, we have the segmented 32 KB of ROM and a single 8 KB of RAM. This bank will be repeated over the remaining memory. A small note here, even though our goal is to backup the RAM, we still need to map the ROM. Why? Because the RAM bank switching occurs within the ROM section, as we will see later when we write the software. As usual for such projects, I prefer using programmable logic devices, or PLDs, because they are versatile and programmable with software. Additionally, they have fast propagation delay, which is crucial for our application. Indeed, the Z80 CPU in Zeal 8-bit computer runs at 10 MHz, which is more than twice the speed of the DMG Game Boy CPU. According to the datasheet of the cartridge RAM chip I found online, even at 10 MHz, it should be fast enough, so it should work fine for us. Everything is planned. Now let's implement the module by creating a PCB that will connect to the extension port of Zeal 8-bit computer. As you may know from my previous videos, I use KiCad for PCB design. The final result looks great. I send it to the PCB manufacturer, and in the meantime, let's move on to the software. Unlike my previous videos, this time I will write the program in C to perform the cartridge dump. Yes, Zeal 8-bit OS also supports C. As a reminder, Zeal 8-bit computer has a virtual address space of 4 pages, each being 16 kilobytes big. Each page can be mapped to any 16 kilobyte portion of the physical address space. Moreover, Zeal 8-bit OS provides an abstraction layer for mapping operations and low-level drivers. Regarding the dumper software, I will use the detailed information provided on gbdev.io, which explains all the cartridge types. You can check it out, I will include a link in the description. The software will read the banks present in the cartridge one by one and send all the data read to a Linux computer via UART. It would be possible to save the data file directly on Zeal 8-bit computer storage, but I want to test the save file with an emulator afterwards. Here is a brief overview of the code. Prepare the UART transactions by opening the serial driver. Map the cartridge first 16 kilobytes within our virtual address space. Print the name of the game, which is stored in the cartridge ROM at address 134 in hex. Determine the size of the RAM chip using the values explained on gbdev.io website. We can print the size only for debugging too. Next, we enable the RAM, which is protected by default. We do this by writing A in hex anywhere on the first 8 kilobytes of the ROM. Then we enable the RAM bank by writing 1 to address 6000 of the cartridge ROM. Of course, we need to map that area to our virtual address space first, as you can see. Finally, we map each RAM bank to read its content and send it through UART. I hard-coded the number of banks to read to 4 because Pokemon Blue uses 4, but ideally we should use the previously determined size variable. Voila! That should cover the software aspect. We can compile it and wait for the PCB to be assembled for testing. And talking about it, after a few days, it arrived. I can't wait to solder it and test it out. Let's do this. It looks great. Honestly, I was a bit worried about the connector not fitting because I made the footprint myself. This is why the pins on the PCB are longer than the ones on the connector. But as you can see, it fits perfectly and I'm satisfied. Time to solder it. I'm going to use my soldering iron for this. With a bit of flux and the microscope, it's quite simple. I check if all the pins are solid thanks to the microscope. The result looks good. The cartridge fits perfectly and it's sturdy. It holds very well. I love it. After finishing soldering the other components on the PCB, it is ready. We can plug it into Zeal 8-bit computer extension port. I will use a UART to USB adapter to communicate and transfer the saved data from Zeal to my actual Linux computer. I flashed the OS and the program I wrote previously to the ROM. We can start testing and I hope everything will be fine. So when I was testing, I was pulling the cartridge out of the computer while it was still on, and the disaster happened. Here it is. The save inside the Pokemon Red cartridge is now gone, so as you can see on the menu, there is only two choices, and the first one is for a new game. It's not a big deal because the save that was inside was not very important, and it was only for testing. But lesson learned, I must not pull the cartridge out without turning off the computer first. I need to be very careful when I will back up my own Pokemon Blue save. I understand better now why when we were young we were told to never pull out the cartridges while the Game Boy was still on. I will continue my tests on another Japanese Pokemon cartridge I have. On my Linux computer, I configured the UART to RAW and I set the baud rate. Then I simply used the cat command to receive the bytes. Okay, we can see that we have the dump.bin program. I execute it. We can see that the transfer is going on the UART adapter. The program just finished and it detected 32 kilobytes of RAM and Pokemon Blue. On the computer, we can stop the transfer and check the content of the save file with a hex editor. Now it's time, we have to reiterate the same process, but with my own cartridge that I want to back up. So let's do the same thing. Let's connect it to the 8-bit computer, power on the computer, execute the dump software, and on the computer, save the file. Hopefully everything goes well. So the backup is now finished, I have my own save file. I'm going to try to load it inside an emulator with the same Pokemon game, the same ROM. And let's check if it works. And yes, it works! Great! I was able to backup my own game thanks to Zeal 8-bit computer. That's very cool. Alright, so that's it for today's episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any question or suggestion, you can leave a comment down below. And see you next time.